Today, I'm pumped to be trying out the Neon Nitro Speed collection from Martine Cosmetics. This is a brand that's totally new to me. This is my first time trying one of their collections, and I am excited to see what this brand is all about. This is a gorgeous eyeshadow palette. It's like summer in a palette to me. We also have a face palette, and it has one bright blush, and the other three, I believe, can work as highlighters. And I also picked up one of their liquid eyeliners in this gorgeous purple shade. Excited to try these things, but I just wanted to mention a few words before we jump into it. So, I've had my eye on this brand for a little while now. This, I believe, is a French brand that's available on Beauty Bay, which is where I purchased this collection. I don't see a lot of YouTubers in the US review this brand, so I have been curious for a while. The first collection that I saw being reviewed on YouTube was by Heather Austin. It was the Martine's Diner collection, I believe. Here is the eyeshadow palette. For me, there was something missing from this palette. I think maybe a few more bright colors. It was pastels, but it was lacking a little bit of that pop of brightness that I enjoy in my eyeshadow palettes. There's another palette that came out. This is the Mission Triple X eyeshadow palette, and for me, this has too many grays or too many of those grungy tones. I don't like wearing a lot of black or gray or too many smoky looks. I prefer something a little bit more vibrant, colorful. To match with my flamboyant taste in clothes and makeup and jewelry, as you can see. And the next one that caught my eye was the Moolah collection, the Moolah eyeshadow palette. Now, this is a nice, interesting palette. It has some greens, it has some neutrals. It's right on par with the theme of the season that we've been seeing. This one is still pretty recent. It says new on their website, and I believe it launched pretty recently. It's not too old at all. The one thing I didn't really like about the aesthetic of this one was the outer cover, which looks like a credit card. I don't like credit cards. It's a personal thing. So, yes, I don't think credit cards are particularly aesthetically pleasing either. So, that was a pass for me. And the color story wasn't too exciting for me. I believe the most interesting color story that I've seen in this green and neutral theme is the Natasha Denona Yucca palette. Not a lot of similar color stories have really been able to pull me in, but the Neon Nitro Speed eyeshadow palette. Now, this is a beauty. It has lots of bright colors, a few lighter colors, pastels, and a couple of dark shades too. But to me, this is one of the most lovely summer bright color stories that I've seen launched this season. So I thought, why not? Let's try it. So, let's get into it. Let's do an eyeshadow look, play with some face colors, and at the end, I will give my thoughts about what I think this compares to formula-wise. So, let's get into it. So, recently, I found out that my eyeshadow base may have been giving an unfair advantage to otherwise lackluster eyeshadows. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put two different primers on the eyes and see which one performs better. This is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter one. This is more of a tacky base, and this is the Glam Light Icing eyeshadow base. And this one is lighter, but not as tacky. So let's see how they fare. Okay, the eyeshadow base is done. This is the Fenty. This is the Glam Light. As you can see, this has more of a white base, and this is essentially colorless but tacky. Let's dive into this beautiful eyeshadow palette. I want to show this again. Look at that bright array of colors. How will I ever decide what look to create? I want to keep it colorful, but also I want it to be the same on both eyes and do a cohesive look. So, let's combine some colors that we wouldn't otherwise think of combining. Also, I forgot to say that the imprints on these are so cute. Exactly in accordance with their theme. So there's like a trophy, there's a road, there's a burning rubber tire, there's a car speeding, there's a steering wheel, traffic lights, like a wrench, a motorbike. Like, it's all so interesting. All of those are different. And there's a parking sign, there's a helmet, there's like a driving seat, and that flag thingy. And in three colors, it says Neon Nitro Speed. Like a no entry sign. So interesting. I must say, they did an excellent job of making this very aesthetically pleasing with the outer packaging and everything. This is what I like in makeup. Like, it is just powders, but how they present it, that really makes it like a little piece of art that you would want to add to your collection. Now, at this point, I am slightly confused because I like the color theme going on the lids, but I also want to use a shimmer. And the shimmers in this are beautiful, but I'm not sure which one goes. Okay, so the palette has this color, which is kind of multi-chromey. You can see it has a shift. Some of these other shimmers, like this one, and maybe this one, these are more of a satin shimmer. This one that I put in the inner corner is gray to a purple to a hint of green, kind of shifty goodness. And I like that there, but I don't want to do a too much shimmer because I'm not feeling shimmery today. I'm feeling more matte. So, what to do? I think I will swatch a few of these and hopefully it'll come to me. So, here are all the satin shades. The majority of shimmers are satins, and these are gorgeous. There's a very metallic silver in here. So, here are the three special shimmers in total. The last one is definitely a multi-chrome. It has like a reddish fuchsia to a gold, to a coppery gold shift. Now, normally I would go for the multi-chromes, but hell, I'm confused. So after quite a lot of deliberation, I have told myself not to overthink it. So I'm going to use this shade towards the outer half of the lid. This looks kind of reddish in the pan, but it reads more pink. I think the satin kind of shimmers might benefit from one of these glitter primers or eyeshadow primers. This is the Bella Beauté Bar Shimmer Stay. Okay, that's not looking the most seamless, so I'm going to add another shimmer. That is, I think, another one of those special shimmers. This is one of those colors that is deemed as a neutral multi-chrome. This is shifty, but the shift is very subtle. Shut up and drive. まみれこの街の演奏玉たまま一度ついておいで世界中魅了するほどに豪華なジャパン一番ジャンプアランサーうちらの出番テリヤキボーイズ in the place to be 見せてやろうオリジナル VIP Many many diamonds dangling Bag full of money we strangling Hate me, fry me, bake me, try me All the above cause you can't get in I don't want no problem Because me professional Make you shake your kettle Thank you Haters take it personal Like a Canada tight heads out now Talk on Let's go Not not you my mind Let's go Hot sun She get you my awesome Let's go Let's go To hear level up On love color Let's go Let's go Need you one girl Tonight need go New dance Sorry not that's your pain point I want So, this is how the eye look turned out. I must say, this took more effort than I was expecting, and it's not my most favorite eye look I've ever done. So, I definitely have to play with this some more to really formulate my thoughts, but let's get on with the face palette. So this is what the face palette looks like. I like the color selection, but I'm wondering What should we do here? How to combine these colors? So the pink shade here is a satin. This is a matte, and both of these are shimmery finishes. So what I'm thinking is I will use the pink as blush on one side and this as highlighter on the same side. And on the other side, I will use the orange as blush and the gold as highlighter. That way we can see what these colors will look like on two different skin tones. This could be for a deeper skin tone and this could be for a lighter one. Let's start with the orange. So on my skin tone, this has more of a shimmery finish. This could work as a highlighter or even wear it like this, like a shimmery cheek. But I think for a lighter skin tone, this could read as a lovely pink shimmery blush. Okay, so let's discuss. So, I really like the warm side. I think it's such a gorgeous color combo, the way it turned out. And the blush is definitely pigmented but blendable. The gold really is more of a subtle gold. It's not overly in your face kind of thing, which looks great. Honestly, I have nothing against it. Then there is the cool tone side. The pink is a beautiful blush, and this highlighter reads a little bit of a purpley pink, which I'm not mad about at all, but it's quite a beaming highlighter. And I like both sides. I can't find a fault in any of these four shades. I feel like this curation is just a little bit different from what we've been seeing. While one side is warmer and might suit deeper complexions, the other side is lighter. What I like about this palette is, like the eyeshadows, they included different finishes. There's a satin, there's a duochrome, there is a metallic, and there's a matte. So that's kind of cool. I like that. Also, I forgot to mention there's tire prints in the whole thing, and it looks adorable. Okay, so I'm going to add a lip gloss. This is from Nomad Cosmetics. This is from their Fête de Provence collection. I hope I'm saying that right. Either way, I don't care. I thought a purple gloss would go well with this, but apparently we don't have a lot of purple in this look except for the liner. But oh well. Okay, that really doesn't go with anything, but oh well. So, final thoughts. I absolutely love this color selection. I think this is a very versatile palette. However, I did have to work a little bit harder with the shadows. I don't know why that is. I would compare the quality to the Cosmic Brushes Delicious Delights palette, which was my last video. This also has a couple of multi-chromes, like the Cosmic Brushes Delicious Delights palette, and a few satin shades, just like, again, that same palette. And the mattes, I find some of them to be good, highly pigmented, and some a little bit sheer, particularly this yellow here. This pink performed really well, especially on this side. I'm not sure what the difference is when you use two different primers. Some of the colors performed better on this side, some on this. Like, as you can see, the blue here is deeper on the Fenty primer side, whereas The pink really showed up on the Glam Light primer side. And the yellow is kind of sheer on both sides. I think I still need to play with this quite a bit more to formulate my thoughts because, frankly, I didn't use enough shades to make a decision right now. However, some of the shades I used, I think the quality could be a little better. They could be a little bit more pigmented. So that is that. Even the silvery blue kind of duochrome shimmer that I used on the inner corner, it seems to kind of fade after a little bit. And this kind of neutral multi-chrome that I used here, this has already faded. So I will definitely need to test it out more, although I do enjoy the aesthetics of it for sure. I think the face palette is a cute little addition to the collection. I am definitely more drawn to the warm side because that suits my complexion more, but the cool side is cute too. I'm particularly fond of this pink satin kind of color. This can be used as a blush or a highlighter. It's an interesting choice for sure. I think this is a good palette. If you're into these colors, there are no quality issues whatsoever. And then there is the liner. I feel like quality-wise, this is my favorite item from the collection. This goes on very smoothly and covers up all the eyeshadow, doesn't tug or pull, and a good enough amount of liner comes out so that you don't have to keep going over and over. And the precision tip is really easy to work with. Creating this winged liner was essentially effortless. Those are all my thoughts on this collection. I think I'm looking pretty colorful. And it unintentionally matched my earrings. Cute. I don't hate it. I think it's cute, but could it have gone a little better? I think it could. Anywho, that is all for my agenda today, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.